Hello, my dear baby, and everyone else, and welcome back to Tammy Village. And now I remembered something about the Undyne armor. Yes, I recall, I didn't check on it, I just recall now better that the text in the cast says something like Undyne by Toby and Undyne's armor by Tammy, or Undyne by Toby and armor by Tammy. So yeah, that's the line that I have been thinking back, and that's the line that I consider to be a little hint that Undyne's armor is actually made by Tammy. So that's the same armor, or you know, similar armor to what armor we can get from Tammy. Of course not the same size, obviously, but you know, the same technique used to it, and that's why it's so powerful. And I also found that I completely missed the top glove among my sellable items, or item to sell, so I'm gonna sell it now. Welcome to the time stop. Yeah, let's sell the top glove for 50 gold only. That's okay. Bye. Hoi. Yeah. And with that, we have enough. Yeah. I still don't have any immediate need for it, so yeah, let's just keep it there. Okay. Okay, let's continue on. Okay. And here, we don't see the road and we can't walk more. So we need to get back here. Okay, and a random encounter. Okay! Okay, this is one of my favorite random encounters in Waterfall. You walk into more small, but notice how the right one is just idler. So the left one we can already spare, but the right one we cannot. So let's check it. More small, question mark. Attack 6, defense 6, defense 0. It's a small, it's a slime mold, and it doesn't even say anything or do anything. More small is having a quiet time. Well, we don't need the other one, so let's just spare that one. And yeah, having a quiet time. Check again. No reaction, and yeah, most small is very normal. This is the one I have been waiting for to appear. More small is very normal, says Chara. Yes, very, very normal. Okay, let's approach it. Flirt! You wiggle your hips suddenly. Wow! Smells like a bait shop. Mold big. Check. Mold big, attack 18, defense 18. One side greater than mold or age. Gwaaah! Mold big needs some distance. So we can lie down, hug and unhug. I will, you know, just for joking around, I will lie down now. You lie down. Moldbig lies down too. Moldbig understands life now. Slime sounds. Moldbig mills about in the corner. So I could hug now. I will show it just because I hug. You hug Moldbig. Ghost slime covers you. Your speed decreases. Gah! Yep, my speed is decreased. Moldbig needs some distance. Okay, let's unhug Moldbig. You don't hug Moldbig. It appreciates your respect of its boundaries. Roar! Yeah, and I'm still having slowed down speed. Oops, and that got me. Okay, Moldbig seems comfortable with your presence. Let's spare it. You got 20 gold. And let's use our night scream. Is this as sweet as you? Your HP was maxed out. Okay, and this is the correct route here. Okay. Without candles or magic to guide them home, the monsters used crystals to navigate. One interesting stuff here, that these crystals here look exactly the same as Icehead's head. So one theory, for example, is that Icehead is just ice that met up with some of these heads here, and that's how it became Icehead. You see, Undertale is full of stories like this. You know, absolutely minute details, and let people just make up theories about them. So yeah, this is a maze. And I have to use the lanterns periodically or it gets really dark. Oh, and a random encounter. Boshu and Aaron. Okay, I can do this. Let's clean me, Boshua. I sure do love muscles, winky face. Oh, no. Okay. Aaron is admiring his own muscle. Okay, let's get rid of Boshua. Don't get too close, winky face. Aaron is looking around, fearful of something. Yeah, this is because of the scary music we played. If we didn't do that, then this would not appear here, this text. Let's flex. You flex, Aaron flexes twice as hard. Flexing contest, okay, flex more, winky face. Oops. Flex. You flex harder. Aaron flexes twice as hard. Attack increases for you too. Nice. I want to lose though. Aaron is ready for your next flex. You flex. Aaron flexes very hard. He flexes himself out of the room. 55 gold. Oh yeah, it gets too dark, but that's okay, I can see the way. Almost. Okay. Oh, I totally forgot something. Cool Papyrus. How could I do this? Lanterns, okay. Can you eat them? No, Papyrus, you can't. I'm seriously out of ideas here. I would try eating them. Yes, Papyrus, we know. Okay, so this is the only new room that we got into. We called Papyrus in Tamis village, and no response, obviously. I would not respond too. And we called him in the Phoebus room. He asked about eating mushrooms. Okay, nothing is lost. Let's call Papyrus. There is no response. Okay. Yeah, behind you. Behind you. Seven human souls. With the power of seven human souls, our king King Asgore Dreamer will become a god. With that power, Asgore can finally shatter the barrier. He will finally take the surface back from humanity and give them back to the suffering and pain that we have endured. Understand, human? This is your only chance at redemption. Give up your soul, or I will tear it from your body. Undyne, I will help you fight. Yo, you did it. Undyne is right in front of you. You got front row seats for her to her fight. Wait, who she's fighting? Hey, you haven't gonna tell my parents about this, are you? Okay. No response. You aren't gonna tell my parents about this, are you? Okay. Let's continue. And yeah, the pet is here. We didn't see it in the darkness. You hear a passing conversation. If I say my wish, you promise you won't laugh at me? No response. Of course I won't laugh. Someday I would like to climb this mountain we are buried under. Standing under the sky, looking at the world all around, that's my wish. You hear a laughter. Hey, you said you wouldn't laugh at it. Sorry, it's just funny. That's my wish too. However, there is a prophecy. The angel, the one who has seen the surface, they will return and the underground will go empty. Yep. And this go empty, of course, have two possible meanings. Either the monsters will go free or we'll all die, and that's why the underground will be empty. Okay. Yo! Yo, I know I'm not supposed to be here, but I wanna ask you something. Man, I never had to ask anyone this before. Yo, you are a human, right? Oh, man, I knew it. Well, I know it now, I mean. And I told me, stay away from that human. So, like, I guess that makes us enemies or something. But I kinda stink at that, haha. You say something mean so I can hate you, please? No. Yo, what? So I have to do it? Here goes nothing. Yo, I hate your guts. Man, I'm such a turd. I'm gonna go home now. Yep. Yep. She got stumbled and she's about to fall down. Yo, wait, help, I tripped. And Undyne will appear from the left and will approach Monster Kid. And if you don't do anything, well then, as Monster Kid will fall down, Undyne will fall down after them and catch them and will hold them as they fall. So Undyne hits the ground first, somewhat limiting the damage to the Monster Kid, and then after which we will fight with Undyne, and Undyne will have a reduced HP because of this, because they capture the Monster Kid and hit the ground first. But that won't happen this timeline. Because I catch monster kid. You dude, if you wanna hurt my friend, you're gonna have to get through with me first. She is gone. You really saved my skin. Guess being enemies was just a nice talk, haha. We will just have to be friends instead. Man, I should really go home. I bet my parents are worried sick about me. Bye, monster kid. Later, dude. Did you just assume my gender? No response, of course. Okay, well, here we go. Excuse me. Seven. And that's, by the way, in the background is Hotland. And that's why it's, the color is also red, because of the heat. Seven. Seven human souls and King Asgore will become a god. Six. That's how many we have collected thus far. Understand? To your seventh and final soul, this world will be transformed. First, however, as it's customary for those who make this far, I shall tell you the tragic tale of our people. It's all started long ago. No, you know what? Screw it! Why should I tell you the story when you are about to die? Nah! You are standing in the way of everybody's hopes and dreams. Office history books made me think humans were cool, with their giant robots and flowery swordswomen. But you are just a coward. Hiding behind that kid so you could run away from me again. And let's not forget your wimpy goody shoe stick. Oh, I'm making such a difference by hugging random strangers. You know what would be more valuable to everyone? If you were dead! That's right, human. Your continued existence is a crime. Your life is all that stands between us and our freedom. Right now, I can feel everyone's hearts pounding together. Everyone's been waiting their whole life for this moment. But we are not nervous at all. When everyone puts their hearts together, they can't lose. Now, human, let's end this right here, right now. I show you how determined monsters can be. Step forward when you are ready. And that's my cue to save. The wind is howling, you are filled with determination. And cliffhanger, of course. See you next time. Bye bye.